This is a demo of readR, a new web browser for iPad with unique features. Unlike other browsers, the controls are pushed to the side instead of on the top and bottom, and they show and hide somewhat automatically. This is to give you maximum vertical visibility, because most web pages scroll vertically. Second, the tabs and navigation buttons are separated, instead of stacked on top of each other. This layout makes tabs and buttons more tall, ergo, more touchable. Also, unlike other browsers, readR can run four web pages simultaneously, as tabs do in a desktop browser. In iPad Safari, inactive tabs are stored in memory. You can come back to them at any time, but you might have to wait. In readR, they are fully live, free to run JavaScript and play sound in the background. This means, among many things, that you can play music videos and MP3s in the background while you browse. The page we're on now is Launchpad, the default homepage. It has links to news sites and search fields for quick access to YouTube and Wikipedia, etc. The four big icons are web applications. The nav bar is a totally normal navigation bar. Home goes to the launch pad or whatever page you assign in the settings. Back, forward, reload, and stop work normally. Type a URL into the bar and hit return to go there. Once the page is loaded, a little thumbnail appears over here on the right in the tab bar. You can see we have three free slots to run other web pages. You can open many tabs in Safari, but put YouTube in the background and it will stop playing. Not so in readR. Let's prove it. Tap on an empty slot to switch to it. Now, open the navbar and tap Home. This opens a new copy of the launchpad over the page that we were just visiting. Notice how the nav and the tab bars automatically close. Here in the YouTube search box, let's search for Marcus Miller. This song is called Power. Since this is a QuickTime stream, we can zoom right into the video and even get scrubbing controls. Switch back to the site that we were on before. Note that the music is still playing. You can see that the line of text underneath the tabs is the classic browser status bar. This is the power of real tabs on iPad. Instant switch, instant close, and fully parallel. Now, if you ever closed a tab by accident, you know that it's nice to have the history handy. Max and Min gives you more room, and of course you can delete individual entries or the whole thing. Right opposite